You're thinking about my baby, it don't matter if you're black or white.
Welcome back to the YouTube channel, the official YouTube channel of Blues Away MJ. Just want to welcome you guys for tuning in, just supporting the vlogs and supporting the channel in general. I just thank you guys for tuning in. So if you're new to the channel, welcome. Please hit that subscribe button. Check out the videos that I've just dropped and enjoy the channel. So today, you guys, I will be bringing you guys along. I want to go to a couple record stores or a record store and or just anything, anywhere, just to try to find some type of Michael Jackson somewhere. It's time to add to the collection. So I definitely want to shoot, get something new. So yeah, just come along with me. And yeah, we're going to see if we can spot some MJ in the city today. So let's go. I already have this bad boy.
That way, you know, let's see. Check out your records.
We got Janet Control. They got the Ultimate Jackson. Wow. Let's pull that to the side real quick. They got Invincible. That's the one I need right there. Woo! Which I think. Really? You see some more? Yeah. Oh, yeah, you gotta get this one. It's $7. Can't beat that one. Can't beat that one. Let's see, we'll put it to the side. And so that's all the jacket. Okay, MJ fam, so right now we stopped and got us some ice cream. Shout out to Bae. Bae bought me the Invincible vinyl. So when we get home, I'm gonna open it up, do a review, and we're gonna put it on the record player. So y'all stay tuned. We're gonna chop and then we're gonna talk. And yeah, we're gonna do the whole Invincible review, vinyl review, once I make it back home. I'm gonna enjoy this ice cream. So we have made it back home, and I just want to say that they had some really, really, really great MJ pieces at the record store today. Now, although I only walked away with one item, I know some of you probably like, oh, why didn't you get everything? I look at it like it's fun, you know, it's a journey. It's not a rush to try to fill up your collection. Okay, it's not a competition. It's not a competition. Yes, some are lucky to retrieve some of the collectible items that they get, but it's not a competition. So just get your MJ collection built up on your own time. So the way I want to start collecting is basically finishing his solo career. So, with that being said, I picked up Invincible. Yes, like, I've been wanting Invincible for some time, simply because I love Invincible. Like, Invincible album is just amazing. Like, it is very underrated. It is a very underrated album. Also, like, just look at the vinyl. Like, you got blue, and then when you open it up, But yeah, so I've been wanting this vinyl for some time. I just, you know, the price of it is $40, but it's worth it. It is worth it. It's Michael Jackson, of course. Then when you open it up, you have the red and you have the green. So, like I said, I've been wanting this vinyl for some time, and I'm super, super excited that I got it today. It was a tough decision because the Jackson 5 Ultimate Collection was another vinyl that I wanted to get. But, like I said, I want to finish his solo career, and I also have History to get. So once I get that one, I'll be done. I'll be done. But yes, for sure, just wanted to get Invincible. It's been some time, been quite some time. You know, man, Invincible, the sound is like no other. Literally, he dropped it, 2000, 2001, going into the 2000s R&B, he was ahead of it. He was already making the music that went on to throughout the whole 2000s. Like, he was already doing it. So it starts off with Unbreakable. Like, Unbreakable is a mean intro to start off this album with, because he's basically going into a new decade, a new year, new era. He's going into a whole new era, and he letting you know, I'm unbreakable. I done been through this era, this era, this era, and it led me here, and I am unbreakable. You cannot break me. Like, you can't believe it. Yeah, you can't believe you can't break me. Then it goes into Heartbreaker. Then it goes into the self-titled track, Invincible. Like, Invincible is crazy, crazy, crazy track. Break of Dawn, like, oh my gosh, what a way to end side A. Then it goes on to side B, Heaven Can Wait. Like, I feel like the transition from Break of Dawn to Heaven Can Wait is like two naturistic transitions. Like, you got something, you know, mellow. After Heaven Can Wait, you have You Rock My World. I feel like You Rock My World is Invincible. I feel like You Rock My World is this album. Like, and I say that because that track alone, with the video, the short film, I mean, it's just brilliant, 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 brilliant. You see his acting more. You see him in a new era, a new swag, a new girl. Like, it's definitely a dope, dope track. Then you got Butterflies, written by Marsha Ambrosius. I hope I'm saying her name right. But the way Mike executed on Butterflies, fantastic, fantastic. Then you got Speechless, which starts off with a mellow, like, acoustic vibe. You just hear his vocals. You hear him coming in, you know. Side C starts off with 2000 Watts, which brings him into the hip-hop lane. So it goes to show, this man was not only pop, this man was rock, hip-hop, soul, like, R&B, like, what? All-around genre, man. Like, he was rapping. He was rapping. It's not even his first rap track, though. It goes back into the 90s. It goes back. Like, so he's definitely showing that I can still break this. I can still do anything. You can see the message. The message he's stating, that I'm unbreakable. And I'm going to leave you threatened by me. Like, that's basically how he ended it. He ended it. I'm gonna leave you threatened by me. Look at the picture, man. Look at the picture. That boy always giving face. Even animation, bro. It remind me like an anime vibe. The whole, what is it? 2000 futuristic vibe. But yeah, I'm just super, super excited to have received this. This is one of my favorite albums. Underrated album. Definitely deserve his flowers. The whole production of it. I really wish he would have dropped some more music videos or short films to, like, some of the tracks like Butterflies or Heaven Can Wait. Shit, or Privacy, man. He should have dropped some more music videos or short films to this amazing album. But, you know, with all that, the rumors or the allegedly, the rollout was not in Sony's priority. Like, they was not prioritizing this album. Yeah, so it definitely deserves his roses and his flowers. So if you would like to stick around, I would love to show you guys more of my collection, because I'm slowly building it. So real quick, I just wanna show you guys some of my collection. I am slowly building it. So just want to show you guys what I have so far. We're going to lay it all out. Yes, sir. That is what it's looking like, man. We have Thriller 40. We have Destiny. We have Jackson's, which is one of my favorite Jackson's albums. And we have my username off of this album as well. Blues Away. Yeah. But yeah, man, I know there's a lot that I'm missing, of course. But like I said, it's no rush to just build up your collection. Have fun with the collection. Have fun with finding these items. Have fun with just, they're treasures. It's not a race. These are treasure items that you want to hold near and dear to your heart, that you want to respect, that you want your family and your friends to respect. These are not toys. These are not games. These are collectible items. These are items that mean a lot to you. So it's no need to rush and try to find different things or, oh, get mad that so-and-so has this and you don't. You know, some things are definitely out of your price range, and I'm speaking for myself, but just have fun with your collection and just build it. With that being said, thank you guys for tuning in to Blues Away MJ. If you like what you see, make sure you hit the subscribe button. Follow me on all platforms, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, at Blues Away MJ. Catch me on TikTok Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays at 6:30 a.m. And let's have a good groove session.